on the block are five teenage heartthrobs in one of the hottest groups on today's music scene. Everything they touch turns to gold or platinum. And now they're into something new. Here's our music reporter, Mark McEwen.
Thank you, Kathleen. Well, anyone in the business will tell you that rock and roll sells more than just the music. The Rolling Stones Steel Wheels Tour, sponsored by Budweiser. Paul McCartney likes Visa. But when you're teen pop stars who just happen to be a cash-making machine, your strategy might be a little different. Just about any move by new kids on the block is guaranteed to turn out a full house. Outside New York's Hard Rock Cafe yesterday, screaming fans waited for a glimpse of their teen idols, while inside, reporters waited for the big announcement.
I think that you'll agree that what you see on the table is most definitely the right stuff.
The right stuff.
The new kids are linking up with the Hasbro Corporation to sell their own line of dolls and accessories.
We've grown up looking at TV, seeing all these toy commercials, and it's always been so flattering, and now we're
plastic
toys too. Do you like them?
Their fans seem to like everything they do. The New Kids on the Block's current album, Hanging Tough, has sold 7 million copies. Their 900 phone line has generated more than $500,000 a month since last March. And New Kids fans spend an average of $11 on merchandise at concerts. That's more than $100,000 per show. Not bad for five kids who came out of a blue-collar Boston neighborhood to climb all the way to the top.
I don't think right now we could see what the best thing about being a new kid on the block is, because we're constantly on the go, we're constantly working, our minds are on other things. But I think, you know,
constantly on the go.
But I think in 20 years from now, you know, when we look back and watch all the videotapes and look at our dolls and stuff, that's when we'll get the best of it.
You know, that day when we're just sitting around having nothing to do, and then we break out the dolls and just start crying.
Right.
And just break down and say, I was famous way back then.
Oh,
I had dolls.
You travel a lot together. You guys ever get tired of just being like a unit all the time, or do you go off on your own?
No, I think, you know, we have our moments. But just like any family, you just go your separate ways for a day or two, you know.
When we first came on the road, we used to fight a lot and stuff. And we got used to each other and you know. Joe's a wise guy, you know. He says a lot of wise things. But not trying to put you down, but I used to get mad, like, you know, a lot of people get mad, but now we just let things roll off, you know, roll
That's
off
just, on that.
Dolls are fine for new kids on the block. But will the dolls be a part of their future when they get older and become maybe new men on the block?
Everyone's so concerned about the future of New Kids on the Block and this and that, whether we're going to be old men on the block. We're just having a ball now, and that's all we're really worried about. We're not worried about tomorrow, you know. And, I mean, Michael Jackson was like 29 when his doll came out, and, you know, men can be dolls too, you know. It's no big thing.
By the way, look for the dolls in August. There are other plans in the works for New Kids on the Block, a cartoon series, a movie, a primetime television special. They're anti-drug. They're good kids. I like them.
Cute kids.
Cute kids.
Five before the hour. We'll be back.